To begin with, Representative Zerwas, like everyone else up here, I just want to thank you for the way you have led this committee. I absolutely have no complaints about that, and I understand the parameters in which you had to work. And with that understanding, I give you very high marks for what you were able to do.
Does that mean a green light on the board? I see.
I do want to ask a couple of questions or highlight a couple of things. Representative Zerwas, you know, in 2013, I passed some legislation that I thought would allow universities to keep those beyond time funds that were collected in their universities, to develop financial aid programs for those students within the universities from which they were collected. You may recall that.
I do. In fact, I was very much involved in some of those conversations that you brought to the committee.
And then when I came back in 2015, I found that nothing had changed. And so at that point, you may recall that I filed legislation to repeal Be On Time, and that legislation was signed by the governor.
I recall it very well.
And you may recall that on several occasions during this last session, while we worked on appropriations, I continued to ask the question, will these be on time funds that we have in the neighborhood, I think, of $91 million be distributed to those schools from which they were collected so that those schools can then create those financial aid programs that we told them they would be able to do to help the students in those universities?
I do recall that.
And you are familiar, of course, with the fact that when the House bill left us, in fact, it did do just that.
It did.
And it came back to us differently in that we are not distributing these funds. I know they're not going anyplace else, but we are holding them to, quote, certify the budget, end quote. And I just want to point out to you, Mr. Chairman, as well as to the members of this House, this is critically important because in our state, we have students who are graduating from college with debt north of $40,000. And if these schools could have access to these funds, it might help those students to lower their average debt load. And I just want to point out just a few of those to you in terms of funds that are due and have not been distributed. Angelo State, $1.6 million. Texas Tech, $14 million. University of Houston, $16 million. University of Texas at Arlington, $19 million. University of Texas, Austin, $16 million. University of Texas, Dallas, $10 million. That's a lot of money that could be used to help these schools with financial aid. So I know we are where we are, but I certainly hope for those people who are going to be on the Appropriations Committee next year that we continue to look at this and insist that this issue be addressed.
I would tell you, and as you know, I share your passion for accessible, affordable higher education, and part of that is through various grant programs that we have. We certainly, as you have noted, do include in the budget the renewals, so nobody who's currently on the Be On Time program will be denied any of the funding that they are expected to have. And you're right, when we looked at the budget and understanding the incredible lift that Chairman Ashby had in terms of getting the Senate up, getting the House down to a place that was at least reasonable for higher ed, you know, that came into play. And I was told that I was going to have to answer this before you, and here is that day. And I appreciate you being so kind and gentle about it. I share with you the intent that we should get that money back to the universities. What I will say, which I think is a reflection of the desire that you and I have to be sure that individuals have affordable access to higher ed, is that we did push more money into Texas grants, and though it's not as high as it left the House, it's still above the current biennium that we're in, as well as TEOGs. And I think that's a statement to this House that we really wanted to keep that above what we had. And that was a significant success for Chairman Ashby to have us end up in that place. And I think it's a huge testament that even in the hardest of times, which this financial cycle is I would rate among those, we continue to put education, both foundation and higher education, at the center of what we do. And all these things put together are examples of that. I would say the be-on-time money, not going back to the universities, and being maintained where it is in the Higher Education Coordinating Board is one of those things that we need to do in a coming biennia or whenever that is. But I can assure you that at least I, as the chairman this time, and to any impact that I might have in the future, I would share your intent that we get that money back to the university so it can be used just exactly as you have articulated.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman, and I certainly appreciate your support and Chairman Ashby's support as we work to get Texas grants up higher and the TEOG. And before the speaker cuts me off, I am so sorry that we cut the Academic Bridge Program at the University of Texas at Dallas, not in my district, but certainly one of the bright spots of something that we've done that's really working. And I just hope in the future, when we have programs like this, where the graduation rate is higher than our state universities, higher than the national average, and where these kids are going into STEM, and where out of a class of 23 at the University of Texas Southwestern Medical School last year, four of them came out of that program.
Yes,
thank you.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Representative Smithy, for purposes.
Mr. Speaker, will the gentleman yield?
Mr. Smith, do you yield?
I yield.
Dr. Zerwas, I just want to amplify what the other previous members have said to say thank you. Thank you very much to you and the other conference committee members for what you did here. There's two factors that I think we need to point out. One is this was a very tight budget year. We didn't have a lot of extra money.
Yes.
And two, the budget that came out of the House was materially different from what had come out of the Senate, both in philosophy and numbers. And I just want to thank you and the leadership in the House and your committee for staying faithful to the House and making the budget work, and most importantly, getting the most important bill of the session out of here on time. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I appreciate that. And I share with you the perspective that I think the fingerprints of the House are all over this budget. You know, it is a consensus document, and therefore it's not the same as it left. But if we look at the work of all the conferees, the committee, and all of you who have given us a tremendous amount of feedback of the things that are important,
okay,
I think you see the fingerprints of the House all over this budget. And, you know, that was one of the initial charges that the Speaker gave me when he asked me about, you know, participating as the chair of this program, is that let's be sure that when people look at this budget, they see clearly, you know, the face of the House. And I'm proud of that. It's never as good as you would like for it to have been, because you do have to ultimately conference it. But it's a good product. It does meet the needs of Texas. And I think that it will get us through this 2 years in a fiscally responsible way, and will set us up well for the coming biennium, regardless of how our economy goes.